This episode of Front Towards Enemy is brought to you by your mom. She's been so, so good to all of us. Thank your mom for me. Would you fuck me? I'd fuck me hard. I'd fuck me so hard. It puts the lotion on its skin, it does this whenever it's told. Put the fucking lotion in the basket. Thought you'd like to have that image burned into your head. Me dancing around my apartment with my little nightie on and some chick's scalp on top of my head. It is a good song, though. I mean, other than the whole, it's always going to be associated with Buffalo Bill with his dick tucked back, friggin' dancing around in his basement wearing some other chick's skin. And listen to it. Kind of has a cool, you know, like I'm really stoned, relaxing kind of feel to it. Or a keep a chick in a deep, empty, dry well in the basement of your house and fatten her up so you can skin her and make her into a woman suit. One or the other. Alright, that's enough of that. How's everybody doing? It's Friday. I don't remember what date it is. It is the 10th, looks like, of May. And we're back again. Interesting day. This is week two of Mr. Happy Guy at Work. Happy, fake happy guy. It's going to be my new character. I think I'm going to make $1 million with fake happy guy. Hello, everybody. How are you doing? How can I help you, sir? Why, no, I'd love to hear about your children and the other boring ass shit that you do every day. Tell me, please. Oh, You're going to be working on that motorcycle, huh? Okay, tell me about especially don't leave out any of the uninteresting shit that you're going to be doing to it. Go ahead, tell me everything. That's what I want to hear. As long as you're happy, that's all that matters with me. Yes, I still have it pent up. I mean, basically I could vent the show. I could do this thing for shit. Every week I could do this show. Basically just venting the crap I put up with at work because I'm such an angry person. I am. I admit it. I have no problems telling everybody that I'm an angry person. But, you know, that's just part of the wonderfulness of me. But in between rants, you do get some good taste. There's little tidbits and little juicy tidbits, fun facts and goofy stories that just delight and entertain. And, you know, if you're only listening, if the only reason you listen is to hear me rant and rave and be in pain, then you know what? If that makes you happy, well, I don't really give a shit. I just like doing this anyway. If it makes you, I don't care if it makes you happy or not. But, you know, enjoy it while you can. Because you never know. Somebody could just keel over the next day. I could be just enjoying the hell out of doing this thing. And next thing you know, I'm friggin' flipped over upside down in a kayak with a fucking lungs full of water. But thought to this weekend, I was sitting there trying to think up stuff for this week, and you know, rewrite some material and pick up some stuff remember some stories from the old days. And I got a couple emails from people that I'm going to read. That's the whole idea. People send in emails, send the stuff in. I don't care if it's goofball stuff. You know, Bill, what do you think I should do about this? Or you fucking suck. Or God, I did this. Or whatever. Just send it in. It's RACXOB68@outlook.com. Send the stuff in. We'll read it. We'll use it as material. It'll segue into other stuff. So you never know. I got some funny shit coming up. The letters are actually really good. They're just prime type stuff. So it works out really well. But send the stuff in and we'll get it going and be part of the show, you know? So what I was, the story I, one of the things I wanted to talk about was I remembered a story in high school about some friends of mine. My friend Matt, me and him knew each other since grade school, and we had gone out with, let's see, who was it? It was myself, Matt, my friend Mike, who lived in the area we were in, and then Danielle and Mary. I think it was Mary. Yeah. So there's five of us. And we were in, I think it was Mary's car. And we went over to Mike's and we said, oh, you know, we have some booze. Mike knows a place where we can go out and party. It's, you know, one of those kid places where they hang out on the weekends, you know. And so we go out and it's called Sofa. We'd been there before. There was a pond to swim in. There was a big rock. It looked like a sofa or a couch. So that's why we called it Sofa. So we go out there and I never knew the story behind this place until Mike let me know that, you know, there's a guy that this is on this guy's property. And if he hears us, he'll usually try to scare you off or whatever. And I don't give a shit. Fuck it. Let him try and scare us off. I don't mind. It's just, you know, it's more entertainment for the day. So we go out there and we've got like, I don't know, somebody got a bottle of Black Velvet and we had some beers and it's just terrible shit. And so we're drinking that and we're all sitting there swimming in the pond and everything. And it's night. It's got to be friggin' 12 o'clock at night, 11, 12 o'clock at night. And it's summer. So we're all out there friggin', you know, in our underwear swimming around. Well, then we get, we come out of the, from swimming and we're just kind of standing around and everybody's kind of drying off and stuff. And you hear this croak. It's a bullfrog. Well, Danielle's ding badass says, there's a cow over there in the dark. And I said, what are you talking about? She goes, you hear that? There's a cow over there. I said, it's not a fucking cow. That's a frog. It's like, that's not a frog. That's a cow. And I said, are you serious? You don't know the difference between a bullfrog and a fucking cow. And Mike is laughing. Matt is laughing. And she swore that it was a cow. There's a cow over there. That's not a frog. So we, you know, after telling her 15 times, it's fine, whatever. It's one of those little tiny green hopping cows. So we're sitting over there and all of a sudden we hear a bang off in the distance. I said, dude, what was that? It sounded like a fucking gunshot. And Mike said, well, it's the owner, you know, back at the edge of his property where his house is, shooting his shotgun. He's trying to scare us off. I said, well, fuck, if he's going to, you know, pull out a gun or something, ain't nothing worth taking some buckshot over just fucking drinking some beers, you know? So he said, yeah, if he's already shooting, he knows we're down there and he's going to fucking come cruising down here anytime. So I said, all right, we'll leave. So we start to, we walk back and it's, I don't know, it's probably maybe a quarter mile from the car to Sofa. So we walk back through the woods and we get to the car and all of us at once is like, we got to go to the bathroom except for Mary. So the three guys just walk in front of the car and start taking a piss. Well, Danielle walks off, of course, like all most women do. I won't say all women because I've seen some women that'll just fucking drop trowel and almost pee standing up like I'm a guy. But like most women, they've got to go and fucking walk way away from everything. Find, you know, a giant fucking wall of bushes, you know, like everybody's going to walk over there and watch them pee. So we're sitting there pissing and Mary turns on the headlights on us and we don't give a shit. We're fucking taking a piss. So we get done. And all of a sudden, blam, the shotgun again. And it's right on top of us. I mean, right, maybe it can't be more than 60, 70 feet away from us. Blam! A shot rings out, and Danielle comes running out of the bushes, screaming, ah! And we're like, holy shit, what the hell? And she's running out of the bushes, and we're like, holy shit, we're opening up the car doors. And she runs by us as we're trying to pile in the car. She's like, he was watching me! And so we're like, what? And we're piling into the car. Me and Mike jump in the back seat. Matt jumps in the front seat. Danielle jumps on his lap. We go screeching out of there. We pull up to Mike's house, which is a couple miles away. And meanwhile, on the way out of there, I'm like, what? What's going on? And she goes, he was standing right behind me. He was watching me pee. So I start laughing. Mike's howling. Matt's howling. And she's like, that's not funny. He shot that gun right by me as he was watching me pee. So we, of course, are just howling. Mary's over there. She's like, got to take Danielle's side because Mary was ugly and fat and she had to have her wingman, you know. So we pull up to Mike's place and we get out of the car. And Matt instantly, as soon as we get up out of the car, he like looks down. He goes, "Oh my god!" And I go, "What?" He goes, "Look at my leg," and his leg is soaked wet. And he goes, "He said she peed on me. She had like cut off the pee when she got the when she got scared by the shotgun blast and the guy watching her piss, and then got in the car and pissed all over Matt's leg. So he's got a drenched leg, and she's don't. It's not funny. He was scared me and this, that, and the other. And oh my god, it was hilarious watching her come running out of those bushes, just panicked. Oh my god, she was. I don't think I've ever seen anybody that scared, because she was, the body was jumping, she was twitching, and that guy shooting that shotgun and her realizing that he was watching her pee, boy. Woo, that had her going. She did not like that at all. I don't even know what happened to her. Her like aunt's house got repossessed or something. She lived with her aunt, and then I never saw her again, but I don't know what the hell happened to her. I'm kind of curious though. I looked her up and I never found her. The other day I was watching, I was on Reddit, and I don't know if anybody's familiar with Reddit, but it's pretty, it's not like it's a fucking mystery. But they put a lot of stuff on there, a lot of pictures, a lot of videos. There's a WTF section, and the WTF is usually like just off the wall shit. It's everything, crazy stuff from weirdest animation to, porn to gore to whatever, deaths, anything. There's anything and everything on there, animals, whatever it is. It's just weird stuff. So, I'm on there and I start clicking on pictures on this thing, and I find a really, really disturbing trend on Reddit. Now, if anybody goes on there, you'll see it. If you go on Reddit more than once, you'll find it. It's the penis mutilations. Now, I don't understand what it goes through the mind of somebody who does the things that they show on this webpage to their dick. I don't understand what's going on in their mind. I don't really want to know what's going on in their mind, because obviously it's so dark and twisted that it might just infect you if you had even a clue what it was. And I don't understand. I just don't understand why you would do that. I'm talking about crazy shit. First of all, I saw somebody who, they were injecting their balls and their dick with saline. And so basically this guy had a set of balls that was about the size of a 10-pound friggin' bowling ball. And his dick looked like a friggin' little Nerf football. I mean, literally, you couldn't do anything with his dick. You couldn't fuck anything short of a fucking paint bucket, because it's so bloated and big. I mean, it's freakish weird. I don't understand why you would want to do that. Why you would want to have a dick that's shaped like a football, literally like almost the size of a Nerf football. That fucked up. Your dick is that fucked up. I saw somebody with, and people shoving shit down in their fucking urethra, into their piss hole. People shoving like a butter knife. One guy had a fucking apple in it. That means he's had to sit there and fucking stretch that dick out with different sized things to fucking shove an apple in the end of his dick. He put an apple in his dick. It's fucking freak. Why would you do that to yourself? Can you possibly even hold back a piss if you had to? If you shoved an apple in your dick? I would think if you just go, "Oh, I got a piss," it's just out. You wouldn't even have a fucking second moment's notice. You'd just be like, "I think I got a piss." Up there goes the piss down my leg. Why would you even do that? There was one guy that looked like they had taken like the head of his dick. Now imagine you take your dick, or imagine some guy taking his dick, if you're a female listening to this, cutting the head so that you go underneath, and right underneath the head, you cut it, say, 3/4 of the way through your dick. So just the top part of it is holding on. So it'd be like a Pez dispenser now. So now you got a penis Pez dispenser where the head flips up. Now you sew up the underside of it and the top of it so that it heals up. So now this is just a Pez dispenser that's all closed up. You reroute your fucking urethra, your piss tube, so that it comes out down underneath your shaft, midway up your shaft. So basically, if you grabbed onto your dick about where your middle finger is, in the inside knuckle of your middle finger, that's where your piss would come out. So, and this guy did this to himself voluntarily. This wasn't even a friggin', this wasn't an accident that happened. This was a voluntary, oh, I want you to cut the head almost off and then sew everything up and then reroute my piss underneath so that I can't just piss like that. It has to come dripping out and I have to basically straddle the toilet bowl and can't use a urinal ever again. What the fuck goes through your head? What could you be thinking with something like that? I don't understand it. I never will. And I mean, there's so many of them out there. One guy had, he had to have 80 to 100 of the needles that you use on the end of a syringe sticking through his balls. Sticking through his balls. There was 80 or 100 of them into his balls. If I even graze my nuts with, if I'm moving wrong and I graze them with my pants firmly, they hurt. I couldn't imagine sticking a needle into it, let alone 100 of them. It's twisted. It's so twisted. And it's so warped. And the people that do that, pretty much, I mean, I really hope that I don't know any of you. I really do. I really hope that you don't come into my shop. I hope I don't talk to you. I hope I don't, because if you'll do that to yourself, who knows what else lurks beneath the surface of that. That's shit. That's Buffalo Bill. That's the fucking guy who was doing his little homage at the beginning of this podcast. Buffalo Bill would do that shit to his dick. I think that's enough on dicks. Yeah, that's enough on dicks. You know, we've had enough. I think that'll cover probably 3-4 podcasts as far as penis talk. I did see about, I don't know, 5 years ago, I was in a grocery store, in line in a grocery store. And I'm just standing there. And you know when you're by yourself standing there in a grocery store, you're just kind of like, you're looking at everything but not looking at anything. You know, you're not really focusing. You're just kind of drifting around or people watching or whatever. And I just kind of noticed the guy in front of me. And I look and, you know, he's a dude that looks like he's, you know, whatever, 50s, whatever, 60s. Early 60s, late 50s or whatever. That's what I'm seeing. And he's got an Aloha shirt on, you know, Hawaiian shirt. And he's got shorts on, flip-flops. And, you know, he looks like a dude, you know, retired dude. Pretty good shape, you know, average looking dude for his age. And it looks like he's retired, just, you know, going to the store, pick up some beer or something. And I'm kind of just glancing down. I glance down at his hand, and I see that his hand has, he's got a couple fingers that are, and I don't know what the name was, I'm just going to call it elephantitis. It's just big. They're kind of oversized and deformed. And I realize, holy shit, this is my fucking vice principal from high school. Because I'm not seeing his face. I just see him from the back, and I see his hand. And I recognize, holy shit, that's his hand. This is, you know, Mr. Godwin. And I'm sitting there like, oh crap. And I'm trying to think up how to approach him. You know, I want to be witty or whatever, but I don't want to say, oh, how you doing, Mr. Godwin? You know, because we're adults now. I don't know Mr. Godwin. And I don't know his first name. I can't remember his freaking first name. And I mean, it's like my officers that I knew in the military. It's hard to call them, you know, hey, Steve, or, you know, whatever, because it's just weird for me. You know, I knew them as sir or captain, you know, whatever. But so I'm looking, I go, okay, I'll just, and I'm getting ready to say something. And then he's doing the same thing. He's just kind of standing there and he kind of just turns a little bit and he turns his head just a little bit. And in the corner of his eye, he looks over at me and he looks, and his head, he does the kind of the RoboCop thing where his eye stays fixed and his head turns and he looks over and he says, how you doing, Burger? And I'm like, oh shit, he remembers me. How bad is it when your vice principal remembers you and it wasn't because I was fucking student class president or valedictorian or volunteered for a lot of shit? It was because I was in his office all the goddamn time. And I said, how you doing, Mr. Godwin? We just kind of BS'd a little bit. And I realized at that point, I never even thought about it until that point. And I said, okay, you know, we just kind of did a little catching up and for about 5 minutes. And I said, all right, man, well, enjoy yourself, have a good life or whatever. And I started realizing, and I didn't even think about it until that moment. That man, obviously I reminded him of himself or he had a soft spot for me or something, because I only got suspended one time in 4 years, and that I should have spent half my fucking school time suspended. I was always getting in trouble. I was always cussing out teachers. I mean, shit, I told one time, I just kind of, in a roundabout way, I didn't say it, burn your house down, but I said something to the effect of, you know, sometimes teachers' houses burn down or something like that, you know, innuendo, and that got me up to the office and police called. But I mean, I only got suspended one time, in which he must have, he was always cool. My file was huge. It was just disgusting how much time I spent in that office. But I didn't realize it then. So if you're listening, Mr. Godwin, I appreciate it. You know, I'm no rocket scientist, but I do appreciate it, and I hope you're doing well out there. I had one more thing that I wanted to do before I got to the email letters. I don't know how many people have ever had this happen, but I had it happen to me just recently, and very recently, and it reminded me of another time. I was out hiking out in Lake Natomas, and I'm getting towards the end of the hike, and all of a sudden it hits me. I mean, I'm just walking along, having a cool time. You know, I've did my, well, however many miles, you know, I'm in, you know, five, 6 miles in, and I've got maybe a half mile left. And all of a sudden I've got a shit. And I mean, it hit me like a freaking freight train. Maybe I have to shit. No, it was like, blam, you have to shit now or you're going to be in trouble. And so you, when your body says that stuff and it cranks it right into full blast, you're like, oh shit. And so you start kind of like stepping at your pace and thinking, okay, if I do this, I can get to the car. If I can drive up to that intersection that's 2 miles away from the car, there's a McDonald's there. I can use that McDonald's. And so I'm walking, I get about maybe an eighth or maybe a quarter of a mile. And my body says, nope, it ain't happening. So I got to go out in the bushes there. And this is a mainly used thing. There's a bike trail. So I luckily found a place to go and did my business, but I was driving back from, we had gone to camping on one Memorial Day weekend out to this lake, Camp Far West. And I was on the way home, and it's, you know, it's a decent clip away from my house. And at the time, and I'm driving, and all of a sudden I've got to go. And I know, everybody does. Everybody poops. I know you do. Even you ladies, you out there, you take shits too. And it kicked into one of those types of situations. And you know, when that happens, you know it's not going to be one of those easy things in the bathroom. It's going to be time-consuming. It's going to be nasty. It's going to be ugly. Sound, smell, the whole friggin' enchilada. So I, of course, decide I'm going to drive all the way home. And I'm not stopping at a fast food joint because it's going to be a bad scene. By the time I got to my apartment, I damn near shit my pants, because I was running up the steps to my apartment, the keys in my hand, like fumbling to try and get the key in there. And when you get in that situation, it's bad. It'd be like fucking Mike Myers or Jason or somebody chasing after you. You're stumbling and trying to get the key in, and you're cussing at it because your hands aren't working right, because you feel like you're going to shit yourself. And you run in the house, you slam the door behind you, you run in the house, unbuckling your pants, running down the hallway, dropping shit all over the floor. You got your pants around your ankles by the time you hit your toilet. When you hit the toilet, you're like Jeff Daniels and fucking Dumb and Dumber, just firing a hole. But yeah, and I know you all do it. I know you all do it. I know you're sitting there going, oh, please. Oh, that's the, yeah, you motherfuckers. Oh, it's all happened to everybody. So don't think you're, you know, I'm the only one. We all do it. We all had it done. Just only thing I can say about it, always have toilet paper handy. If I hadn't had my stuff in the hallway or on the trail, I'd have been in trouble. I'd have been tearing up my fucking t-shirt. And nobody wants to do that. You don't want to tear up your t-shirt for fucking for taking a shit, and then you go, oh, okay, there goes a $20 fucking t-shirt down the toilet. Or literally. But let me see here. I'm trying to open up some where's it at? I'm trying to open up some my letters here that I've got. And there, no, there we go. All right. There we go. All right. This one is from Stacy89. I didn't know any of these people that are on here, so I just, these names are, I have no idea who they are or anything. But they were good enough to write, which gives all of us entertainment. And I love it. So Stacy89, if you're out there listening, love you. Says, Bill, I was listening to your podcast and laughed my ass off. Thank you. From what I have heard, we have the same outlook on a lot of things. That's terrible, Stacy. You don't want to be like me. I was listening to you talk about the blanket lift in bed and decided to try it. The reaction was great. My boyfriend immediately turned to me and said, "You nasty bitch," and started to fan the covers. I lost it and couldn't stop laughing for 10 minutes. Thank you for helping my relationship. Stacy 89. I love you, Stacy. I've never heard of a woman doing that. I think that's fantastic. That's awesome. I think more ladies should do that because you're missing out on a wonderful thing. Guys have been doing that. The Dutch oven, the blanket lift. We've been doing it for a long, long time. And if you can get more ladies to do that, by all means, you know what? Get out there and promote that. I promote stinking somebody out because it's hilarious. Let's see the next one. Dude, you crack me up. Keep saying funny stuff. Bud Stud 420. You crack me up. Keep saying funny stuff. Well, when I was talking about the fucking potheads that come into my store, smoke much weed before they come talk to me, obviously Bud Stud here is one of them. Either that or he's really Bud. His name is Bud, and he's a stud, and 420 is his address or something. Because, I mean, it could be. Man, dude, you crack me up. Keep saying funny stuff. Or, you crack me up. Keep saying funny stuff, man. That I kind of, I know it. I know it's some pothead. But I just see it as the hillbilly thing. I had a run-in in Carthage, North Carolina, with a bunch of hillbillies. And we were doing a thing where Special Forces, they have their school, and we were being bad guys for them. We were simulating a supply line. So we'd drive a truck down a road, park for an hour, then we'd drive it back down the road, park for an hour. And we'd do this for all night long or for a whole day, and then we would stop, and the next day we'd do it for them. It was just so they could set up an ambush and stuff. And we're sitting there, and these two kids come walking. We're parked for this hour, waiting to go back down the road, and these two kids walk up. And it's a little fat kid, probably about maybe 12, and a littler kid, you know, maybe, I don't know, maybe 9 or 10. And they look like, you know, kind of reminds you of Scott Farkas and his little toady from the Christmas Story, except the kid was fat. And he's like, what are y'all doing? We're, you know, we're doing this. We're kind of explaining to him, you know, what it is and everything. And soldiers, yeah. And he's, and so he said, you got any of them MREs? And meal's ready to eat. And I said, nah, man, you ain't getting none of our MREs. We got to eat our own food. And he said, where are you from? He's looking at me. And I said, I'm from California. And he didn't miss a beat. He said, do you know Tom Cruise? And then I saw the guys behind him, my buddies, just biting their lips. And which was great because usually they're pretty good about that. They would give you a second to try and come up with something, you know, and if you didn't, then they would freaking pounce on it. And I immediately said, yeah, me and Tom, we surf all the time when I'm back at home. Holy cow, you know Tom Cruise, he makes good movies. I said, yeah, Tom's really good. He does a lot of good movies, you know. And the guys are just cracking up. And so then one of my friends says, man, where's all the women around this place? You know, we're out in the middle of the country. There ain't no women out there. Nothing, none of them with a full set of teeth anyway. And he says, the little kid, or no, first he said, man, is there a little store around here? I need some chewing. He goes, man, I got some chew. I got Copenhagen right here, and I got some Red Man right here. And he pulls the stuff out and gives my friend a dip, and he says, where's all the women around here? And the kid says, man, you give me 6 or 7 MREs, and I'll get you some women. And so my friend says, all right, man, I'll do it. And so he flags down the first motherfucker that he sees pass down this old beat-up pickup truck, and he flags him down. He says, Mr. Johnson, hey, give me a ride down to such and such. I'm going to go get these guys some women. And him and the other little kid jump in the truck and take off. And I'm thinking that they probably said, no, you're not going to go get them some women, because I mean, we never saw the kid again, but it was an interesting time nonetheless. I got one here. This is really interesting. The Moral Majority wrote me a letter. I was listening to your podcast and heard you talking about taking LSD and driving around. You should think about taking that episode down or editing it. Yeah, I'm going to do that. You're going to fucking see me do that shit. Promoting drug use is not something a responsible adult does. I've never claimed I was responsible. We have enough problems in this world. We don't need you getting more people to do drugs. Signed, Concerned. Concerned, fuck you. Fuck you and fuck your family. I don't give a shit what you think. First of all, I wasn't promoting drugs. I was talking to a story about doing them when I was young and dumb. I'm not going to say drugs are bad. I'm not going to say they're good. If you want to do them, you do them. Just keep your shit out of my face. Second of all, I wasn't driving around. My friend was. I wouldn't drive around because I know I would crash into some car or kill somebody. But even so, fuck you. You know, I'm not going to, there's no way in hell that I would take this down or edit it. What makes you think that because your stupid fucking borderline Westboro Baptist churchy kind of letter or leading to, I won't say it can't be borderline. It's not borderline that, but it's that's what leads into that type of shit. And if you don't know what Westboro Baptist Church is, that's the God Hates Fags Church. Google it. They're fucking human filth. But concern yourself with other shit. You're really wasting your fucking time. Please don't listen to my podcast if you're going to fucking... Actually, I like your letter. I'm glad you wrote it. But you're a fucking moron, and you're going to get chewed to pieces if you ever write me again. Okay. Concerned. She's just... Or he. One or the other. Or just concerned. They're concerned that I'm promoting drugs and turning everybody into a bunch of friggin' potheads. All you impressionable minds out there. Because I know there's just so many young souls listening to this. Here's the last letter I got. Dear Bill, I'm a horror movie fan as well. What is your favorite horror movie and why? Derby Day. My favorite horror movie is probably the original Halloween. The original Halloween was fantastic. Although I am a huge zombie fan, love the zombies. Anybody that knows me knows that. I read a lot of zombie fiction, watch a lot of movies, but Halloween, I think it's the benchmark. That's the movie that started it all. That's the movie that really set it up. You got that unstoppable character, that unstoppable thing that just keeps coming and coming and coming. And I think that's just fantastic. It was great. It didn't have to show blood. It didn't have to show people getting their heads cut off. All you had to do is imply it. And like any good horror movie knows how to film. They don't have to. It doesn't have to be gory. Well, everybody, that's the end of this week. Hope you all have a good weekend, and I'm gonna put my robe back on and practice a few more dance moves. See y'all later.